Hello, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a Lego classic town set from 1981. This was simply called Ambulance, and it came with 63 pieces. This poor vehicle has seen better days, hasn't it? I mean, it has been beaten up, scratched up, chewed up, just abused. But you know, that's a good sign, because it means that it's been well loved. It's been played with quite a bit. Back in the old days when it was owned by little kids and not by collectors, and that's exactly the way things should be. This thing is pretty long for a vehicle, for a four wide build, you know, given such a narrow little thing as they were back then. They put some real bulk into this thing, and I think it looks pretty good. You know, I like the color scheme. I like the colors with the transparent pieces. I appreciate that they went with two plates high up on the top with the light bar there. They even put in kind of a simulated skylight. This isn't actually, it's a see-through 2x2 plate, which is very rare nowadays, but there's no hole in there, so it's not actually gonna let light inside. These side panels are printed. Those, you know, no stickers involved there, and these rear ones are actually see-through as well. They were trans clear. So that's pretty cool, and you may have just seen the doors back here, the shutters on this window piece flapping about because they're very well worn. And you can see down inside of there, see it lets a nice amount of light in. It's actually cool that the transparent panel pieces on the sides get kind of frosted over time. You get a stretcher with this set, which fits all the way in there, which is exactly what you want to see for a set like this, and there's plenty of room to push it all the way in, and you can actually place a minifigure on there. There's plenty of room for any kind of figure to fit in there lying down, and you would just attach the feet down here on the backs of the legs. So, you know, play-wise, that works out just like it should. Two minifigs, one male, one female, both also very worn down. You can see identical prints for the torsos. Got that nice classic twin tail hairpiece for the female character. These are great. This is, you know, fits in with the color scheme just right. It's nice that they used back then all interchangeable, non-gender specific pieces. This is just good stuff. And there's what they look like from the back, complete with scuffs and scratches and discoloration and all. The best thing is that they could actually hold the stretcher and they could walk it to the ambulance. That's just a great look. One thing I did notice here though is that one of the hands is not correct. This hand right here is newer than the other three hands included in this set. You can tell just by the color. These older ones were slightly translucent actually. You could see through them just a little bit. So quintessential classic Lego this is. It's pretty much perfect for its era. It has the right play value to it, being able to actually put a stretcher in there, put a person on a stretcher and put them in there. It's got good recognizable colors, nice pieces, two minifigs when they could have thrown in just one. This is absolute perfection for Lego from that day. Or at least I think so. Do you think so? Let me know. Post up a comment with your thoughts. If you don't think this is very good, hey, feel free to comment anyway. It's always good to see different opinions from different people. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video, and I hope that you'll come back for more, because more are on the way. Talk to you again soon.